Hi guys, my name is Erica, and I want to tell you about how I have been bullied by everyone because I am fat. I will really be understood only by those who are in the same situation. And you know, I was always very hurt to hear such phrases as fatso, sausage, piece of fat, and others not very offensive to me. I did not know where to put myself and how to hide my flaws in the body. But I didn't have that because I ate a lot. No, I did. But it wasn't just that. I had what turned out to be a big problem with my hormones. And in case you didn't know, it seriously affects the figure in both girls and boys. Anyway, my story begins in high school and continues to this day. In class, I always sat at the back table. And in gym class, I was taller and stood first. Sometimes the boys would throw a ball at me to watch my belly dance from the vibrations. Not only did being overweight give me problems like looks, but I also ran awkwardly, walked long, and often gasped for breath. Shortness of breath. I was also quickly tired, so I hated sports, which, by the way, also made me sweat as if I had walked in the pouring rain. For this reason, I only had big black clothes, t-shirts, sweatshirts, hoodies, no dresses, no swimsuits, no heels. True, once I did wear my mom's shoes. We all went to a music party at school. There was supposed to be dancing after a small concert. Everyone was told to dress up. I picked out a dress for over a week. Finally, my look was ready. My old friend Pete picked me up. He froze at the sight of me. In fact, Pete and I had been friends for years. I don't even know how our friendship was so strong. He just adores me, loves all my jokes, and is always supportive. He has never once in our years of friendship said anything bad about me, about my figure. Pete has been a real friend. I think that's my compensation for all the things people around me say to me.
Wow, 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 you are a princess.
You're always so bad at compliments.
Why? I'm telling you the truth. This suits you so well.
Thanks, I'm not sure about the shoes. I don't even know how to wear them.
If you want, we can swap. I'll give you my shoes.
And you'll wear mine?
No, I'll carry them. I'm a boy.
Yeah, I know. You're a boy. A very thin, shorter boy than me. My feet are twice your size, so I just don't think I'll fit in your shoes, but thank you. Shall we go?
Get in, madame.
As I got in the car, I felt it settle down a bit. Pete understood everything from my facial expression and immediately said that it's okay. Everything is fine. That didn't reassure me, but I smiled anyway. By the time we got to the concert, I felt like I should have stayed home for nothing. Pete got out of the car and held my hand.
Why are we doing this?
You're a princess tonight, and I'm gonna woo you.
Immediately, there was wild laughter from outside. It was our classmates. They started bitching about how we were like an elephant and an ant, that I was ridiculous in my black ball gown. And Pete looked like a first grader in his costume. I was in pain. Pete took me inside. And just as I entered the hall, I tripped on the threshold, stepped on my own dress, a piece tore off. I flew back, tripped again, broke my heel. Pete reacted quickly, ran up behind me to catch me, and I collapsed right on top of him. They took him away in an ambulance. I broke his arm. That same night at the hospital, his mother came up and said it was all because of me, that our friendship was too much for her son, and asked me to never come into his life again. Out of desperation, I didn't even tell my mother anything, just apologized for the broken heel. They put a cast on Pete. He tried to call and write to me, but I decided to take his mother's advice so I wouldn't kill him next time. So I was left all alone. I tried to go to the doctors, but they all said no. My treatment had been going on for 3 years. I took a bunch of hormone pills and nothing helped. Then I decided that this was it. The end. I would be like that forever. At my last appointment, the doctor told me,
"Try to fall in love."
What? How's that?
It's hard to explain, but love awakens certain hormones in us that makes the body work differently. When we're happy, we don't binge eat, we sleep better, and we don't worry about our problems.
What kind of doctor are you? What nonsense! I freaked out and left. And I thought to myself, how can you order yourself to fall in love with someone? How? This is sudden. I have never done such a thing in my life. But on my way home, a car stopped next to me. A guy got out, called himself Dan, and asked me to meet up with him. I couldn't believe it. I tried to leave, but he swore that I was the most beautiful woman he'd seen. He stalked me like that for about 2 weeks. And then I said, what if he is my chance to lose weight? We started hanging out, dating even. I felt really good with him. One day we met Pete in the park. I just lowered my eyes and we walked by. Dan kissed me that day. I have no idea how, but I really started eating less. Within a week, I had already lost 3 kilos and I had lost 2 centimeters on my stomach. Slowly, I was falling in love with Dan and couldn't believe we'd met like this. Meanwhile, Pete started texting and calling more and more, but I ignored it. Dan asked who it was. I told him everything and he asked me not to talk to him. I did as he asked since I don't communicate with Pete anyway. That's how it went for a month and a half. And then Dan invited me to his pool party. At first, I didn't want to go. I thought for a long time about it. But Dan said he'd be offended if I didn't go. That day, I just walked out of the door of the house, and Pete was standing outside. Pete, what are you doing here?
Don't go, please.
Go where?
To your boyfriend's party?
How do you know? Who asked you here anyway?
Look, I'm still your friend. I never meant you any harm.
Yeah, but your mom told us not to talk anymore. She's afraid for your bones. So, sorry. I gotta go.
Erica, please don't do this.
No, Pete. Bye. I went to the party where there were other girls. They were all racing around in bikinis. The guy had abs. The girls, too. And I was the only one who walked sideways and still hit the glasses on the table with my belly. In the middle of the party, Dan asked me to go swimming with him, but I refused. He started begging and then the guests clapped, asking me to swim with them. They got me, I took off my shirt, and there were noises from the crowd like, ah, my eyes! She's even fatter than she is with her clothes on! I turned to Dan, and he walked over to his friends and said,
That'll be 100! I told you I'd strip her in 2 months! It's been 1.5!
I couldn't believe he would do that! I went up to him and asked him what the hell was going on, and he said,
I'm sorry, baby, it's business. You were easy to scam, and I always like easy money. You didn't think I really liked you, did you?
His words hurt my heart. I put on my t-shirt quickly and ran to the exit, and there was Pete. You knew everything, didn't you? You knew everything and you didn't say anything?
I tried to stop you.
You could have told me.
Would you have believed me?
He was right. I wouldn't have believed it. Because I was in love. Like an idiot.
Don't cry. Let's get out of here. Let me just do one thing.
He went back to the guys, found Dan, and punched him in the face. The crowd was shocked. Dan didn't take long to punch him back. Pete fell in the pool, and everyone laughed.
What did you expect? Even a cow like her won't fall for you.
What? Pete, what's he talking about?
Haven't you seen him? He's got a huge crush on you.
Pete, is that true?
Dan, how much do you know about this? Show me one girl that you've ever had feelings for that's as genuine as mine. Show me one guy who's ever loved as much as I do.
I've known her since she was a little girl, and I've never met a girl as smart and educated and beautiful on the outside and inside as she is. I don't care what you think of her figure. Because you're not even worth her pinky finger. She's 1,000 times better than you. And if she'd let me, I'd be there for her always. And I'd protect her every day from shit like you. They stopped talking, and he took my hand, and we drove away from there. We were silent the whole way. And then I kissed him. And that's how a new relationship was born. It's been a year since then. I've lost 4 sizes. Sure, I'm still a little fatter than Pete, but I'm not the same. Doc was right. Love is chemistry.
Hi, everyone. I'm Amber. There are a lot of rumors about me at school, and they are not the most pleasant for me. And all because I have the biggest butt. Do you think this is a good thing? Then listen to my story, and you will draw your own conclusions. Do not forget to write your opinion in the comments, like the video, and subscribe to the channel. Life at school is not easy. There are criteria by which you are evaluated. It's easier for guys. You're either a popular athlete or a quiet loser. But for girls, it's much more complicated. We are judged by character, appearance, even connections. There's a girl in my class. She's the principal's daughter. Everyone avoids her, constantly thinking before talking to her. Yes, maybe they're afraid of her, or they respect her, or they just don't want her to report everything to Daddy. Sometimes I envy her because she has a quiet, measured life. I'd like one too, but that's not what I have. You'd be surprised if I told you that I'm popular too, but I'm not one of the four local rich people. Nature has given me something very big. The fact is that since birth, I have had a big butt. You will say that there are problems much worse than this. Considering that now many girls work out to try to achieve this, I would like to get rid of it. In general, it all started in childhood. My mother could not find any clothes that fit me because I stupidly couldn't fit into any pants. They got stuck on my buttocks. My mother had to buy pants several sizes larger, sew them at the waist, and shorten the length. She said it was funny, but it wasn't funny to me at all. For this reason, I wore skirts and dresses that there were no problems. I'm not even talking about the underwear that my mother bought for me as a teenager, but sometimes even the skirts didn't save me. My butt bulged out like a sail. I felt like a sheep, which is what they called me at school. The older I got, the more rumors were spread about me. Everyone stared at my butt, turned around to look at me. At those moments, I wanted to sink into the ground. When I was 13, I found a way to deal with this stress. I started eating. I ate everything I could find in the refrigerator at home, ate at school, and ate on the way to school. I especially wanted to eat in public when I was the center of attention. In general, after 2 years, I became even bigger, and all because the calories I ate went exactly where I didn't want them to go. At the age of 15, the school chairs were so small for me that 2 chairs were placed for me as an exception. It was so humiliating, but I couldn't just sit on one. My classmates took photos surreptitiously, distributed them, and discussed them in loud whispers. All I wanted was to be left alone. And only my mother said that this isn't bad, but on the contrary, it's a matter of pride. A woman's curves are very beautiful, she told me, but I didn't think so. A year later, when teenagers reached the peak of the hormonal jump, the guys began to get handsy. They could not pass by me just like that. They always tried to touch or pinch me. Then there were rumors that I had some kind of augmentation surgery, but that's nonsense. Allegedly, they wanted to make sure that it was natural. But no one ever asked me how I felt about it. It was hard carrying a load from behind. After a while, varicose veins appeared on my legs and my mother and I had to treat them. And then I met a guy on the internet. His name was Clay. I didn't post a photo below the waist, and he liked me. He came to my city 2 months later, moved with his family, and came to my school. When I first met him in the hallway, he was so happy, but then he saw my whole body. He slowed down and then said hello, and he couldn't take his eyes off my lower body. Everyone noticed this and started laughing. I couldn't stand it and ran home. I asked my mother to transfer me to another school, but she wouldn't even listen. After all, it was the best school in the city. Then I asked for a reduction operation, but my mother was against me going under the knife. A day later, Clay came up to me again. He apologized 100 times and then offered to take a walk with me. At first, I didn't want to, but he talked me into it. During the walk, I learned that Clay is an amateur photographer. He invited me to participate in a photo session, and before I declined, he showed me some pictures of his work. They were not just normal girls. Some were full, some didn't have a leg, an arm, but they looked just amazing in the pictures. I take these photos so they can see themselves from the outside and understand how beautiful they really are. Just like you. You are more beautiful than any girl I know, and I want you to see it. he told me, and I agreed. We had a photo shoot out in nature. At first, I was embarrassed, but then I relaxed and it gave me confidence. The very next day, the pictures were displayed on his page on social networks. Clay has about 1 million followers, and they were all crazy about my photos. I woke up that day as a celebrity. At school, I was already perceived differently, treated with respect, and from that moment on, I never heard any mockery against me. A few photos changed my life so much. Clay let me know that I was beautiful, much more beautiful than anyone who had ever slandered me. I finally realized this and accepted myself. I was no longer shy about wearing pants. I was no longer shy about my body. I was even proud of it. So, a lot depends on our own perception. And if you doubt yourself, just look from the outside and love yourself. Then the people around you will never dare to offend you again, because you will start to respect and appreciate yourself. Do you agree with my opinion? If so, please write why. And if not, give at least one reason not to love yourself.